Hello YouTube, welcome back to OpenTTD with Lieutenant Joker, and this is really strange. I have no headphones, and when I have them in, they really cut off my ears, so I hear nothing but the game sound. But sorry for the delay on the video. I had trouble with my eyes, so I couldn't really play or record a lot. But we're going to continue. And last time we left off when we connected up this city, and I'm thinking about extending this line. I've actually thought about this a little bit, and I'm not 100% sure how I want to do this, because there's actually not a major town anywhere remaining. I'm not sure whether this counts as a city. Check. This doesn't look like a city. Cities usually require food and goods. Oh, this one requires... What? Oh, that's not the cities. I actually found out, by the way, why this is. Apparently, it depends on whether the city square... So, the immediate middle tile here where the city name is, so this house here, whether that is on a desert tile or not. If yes, then they need food and goods. Apparently, they don't need that otherwise. Yeah, these seem to be on green territory, I guess. And this one isn't? No, this is definitely on desert, and this one is also on desert. That's why they need it to grow. I also found out that apparently I'm doing a little bit something wrong in terms of city growth. I've looked it up, and apparently your city grows if you deliver up to five stations inside the city limit. The cargo doesn't matter. You can be passengers, mail, can be any other industry, goods or fuel or whatever, but it must be in the city limits. So whenever you click on the tile, it needs to say local authority that thing. So if I do anything here with that oil refinery here, then I'm not in the confines of the land. So I'm pretty sure that's how it works. So you can have up to five stations that count. You can have more, of course, but those don't improve your city growth anymore. And that means that, what I'm doing here, basically joining up a lot of these stations, apparently isn't the best way to do it, because right now we have Bohara Main Station, we have Bohara Builder's Yard, and we have Bohara Central. Those are three, which means I'm lacking two. To make this actually better. This is Bohara Oil Wells, but as you can see, when I click on this, this is not in the local authority of Bohara. Neither is this one. So this is not in any local authority. So that doesn't help me. So I would need two more stations in here to make Bohara grow faster. Now this all isn't a big problem for the big city, since they grow double speed. Apparently any town that starts up as a city, there's a certain percentage of towns that start up as cities, they grow double speed. So that's not a problem, but that's probably why these aren't growing that fast, because I only have one station in them. I doubt that this is actually in the city confines. No, this might become part of the city once the city grows faster, but I should invest in bus services in all of these towns and regular bus services as I did in the last Let's Play, but I won't do that. The reason why I won't do that is because I'm still working with horses, and I'm definitely not going to do that with horses. I'm waiting for normal buses, because horses are a nightmare. Especially since they're several tiles long, they block way too much of the road, so they're a nightmare. And I'm not going to do that. Once I get regular buses, I'm going to introduce those. Another thing that I wanted to do here is link up these entire areas, but there's no big city, so I'm not really sure whether I should extend the passenger service that way. If I don't extend it that way, I should possibly rework this and use this line just to connect up some of these cities in a regular way with a different passenger line. But I'm not going to do that right now either. I'm going to try and extend my passenger line, my regular express line, up into this area and try to put a station right in the middle here. So I basically going to try to link up these two cities into one and use one major station in here. I'm also not going to extend this any further since I don't see any major towns anymore. Well, maybe except this one. Can we extend it up to that point somehow? Well, that's gonna be tricky. Maybe if I come down here diagonally and put the station right here in the middle somehow, and then I can tunnel under it and go up there. Alright, I'm going to try that and put a station in here and a station in there and try to link up this entire area. I'm going not to go past these cities, I think, and if I'm going to pass them, I'm not going to build passenger stations there just yet. I'm going to go past them since I just want an express line that goes only to the major towns, and I'm going to link those up separately. So see you after I'm done. And there we go. As you could see, I changed quite a number of things. I didn't go to this town. I'm going to integrate that into a separate passenger line, and I'm going to potentially integrate another passenger platform here. Right now, the express trains are going right past all this, go right up here to this town, and right up there to that town. And here I integrated another thing. I integrated the siding station, where trains will go to the depot and then wait here until there's room enough in the station. And as you can see in the orders, they go first to the end station. There they unload and leave empty, which means, okay, that's the end of the line. They're not gonna load anything up. They're going to go to the sidings. They're going to go into the depot for servicing. Then they go back to the sidings, and then they wait until there's room here, and then they're restarting their route. I've seen this in another Let's Play of another person. I don't remember his name. You can look it up if you search in YouTube, building a country. There he's playing. Unfortunately, he doesn't seem to be continuing his Let's Play at the moment, but the few episodes that he has are pretty interesting. And he uses these sightings. He uses them basically for timetable orientation, because this is the sightings are the place where trains can wait to compensate for any problems with the timetable. I don't have any problems with the timetable since I use the automation here anyway, but I think it's still a nice thing, and I think even the automation can use that to balance out the timetabling. I also doubled the train constants. This is really a major distance that we have here. It's a huge distance. And I also used a number of different bridges, since last time someone told me they don't like that I always use the same bridges for my train lines. Also here, so I'm using some other bridges now. I hope you guys are happy with that. And it seems that it works out. It seems that the passenger trains are actually doing what they're supposed to do. I also might actually want to change this around a little bit. There we go. Have one two-directional platform, and the other ones can use the one-directional platforms. That should work out fine. Then they should go into Buhare, and then they should continue down the line down onto this. There's currently no passenger train here. Let's see whether anyone is arriving. I probably confused the hell out of them by deleting all the orders and reinstating them. I also think I have something wrong here. I think there should actually be a connection here. I'm pretty sure that one is missing. And I also think it might be beneficial if there was a line like this also. I'm not sure, but I'm going to use it anyway. So, there's a passenger train arriving here. By the way, why is this signal like this? This should be a one-directional signal. There we go. Actually, come to think of it, these should all be one-directional. Let's follow this train. He should now go into Buhare main station. Oh, there's already one down there, so let's follow that guy. It's loading up here. Of course, we need bus services in all these towns, but as I mentioned, I'm going to add those later. That will, of course, make sure that right now we have pretty bad services in those towns, since I'm not really connected up to the towns, but I don't really care about that. I still have a lot of balancing in my cargo lines to go, so I don't really mind. Once we have proper buses, which is only 11 years or so away, I think we can do a lot better than... If you want me to instate those anyway, I can do that, but I probably won't be able to do it with proper coverage. Since I will very much limit the number of horses that I use, horse coaches that I use, because I don't really like them and they are problematic. Because as I mentioned, they're several tiles long and that blocks a lot of the city regularly. A lot of the streets. And that's not a good thing. Okay, this is working out, so let's look at the other end, which is right up there. Yes, as you can see, we have trains waiting in the sidings. He's loading up. Oh, he's actually loading up quite a bit, so apparently there's enough passengers waiting already without actually connecting it up. Well, that's good. And they're already starting to spread out a little. I can probably add a lot more. Yes, this line is still way too empty, so let's add a few more. How many do we have right now? 12. Let's make it a full 20. I think that's actually required here, because this is a huge line. We go. One more, and this line will be pretty busy. There they all go. As you can see, we could send all of these off before even the next one is arriving, so this is really not too much for a line this big. And we can pretty much try to hook this, to connect these towns up. What are you? Oh. Wrong tile. Wrong command. There we go. This actually looks a little silly. Oh, that should be a pretty good basis for these guys to grow around this station. Also already include them in the actual... I also wanted to transform these into proper one-sided ones. Did I confuse this guy now? No, 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 buddy. You're completely wrong. Oh, he actually can't go there. No, turn around. What are you doing? Jeez. There we go. Apparently, yeah, apparently I didn't give these guys the possibility to actually cross. That should be fixed now. There we go. So that's that one. The other ones already have that signaling, yes. And this one doesn't need any signaling because it's a terminus station. It's also pretty important that you make sure that this station doesn't have any load orders or unloading orders, because otherwise this might actually become a normal station and you will see passengers here, so you don't want that. And you make sure before the first train arrives here, because once one train ever tries to load something here, it will actually try to get something. Although it probably isn't in the reach of anything, so I built it far away enough of any towns or industries, but still, it could happen, so make sure siding stations don't have any load orders. So these still need some time to spread out. But they will eventually. Let's see whether this now works, because now it should use a different platform. Actually, now it doesn't need this crap anymore. Because now it will always use the lower station, and that one does have a connection. Though the problem was only that it used the upper platform when it shouldn't have. So it was originally constructed correctly, and just to make sure, this actually grows into our new area here. Let's make sure these towns grow for a little bit. Once we get a bus service in here, we'll make these grow naturally. What's the situation here? Oh, there's enough passengers waiting, probably because we're right next to the hotel. Yes, this is working out fine. So, to end the episode, let me go right back into our cargo flow legend. And let me see how we're doing in terms of cargo. So the diamonds seem to be all right. Mail, I'm not interested in. Oil, this is still seemingly a problem there. One more oil train. No, I wanted you to stay open. There we go. Oh, there's still a problem here too. So that's all right. And there's not enough to go around here. And then we're actually not delivering at all. Oh, yes. So one more oil ship. Everything else seems to be alright. Goods, grain, I'm still not interested in. Wood. Oh, that's red. That's not good at all. Yes, there's tons of stuff waiting there. One more. Wood is still not getting transported properly from this place. Alright, that seems to be alright. That isn't alright at all. See, this is also problematic. All these little cargo coaches, they're not performing either. Okay, copper ore. Holy crap, that's pretty bad still. Same here. Okay. Also from this place, but that's already nearly getting covered. But not from here, not from the actual station. Still not perfect. This is really dark red. I'm going to add another one there. And then we need another ship. Of course, this is kind of self-explanatory. Once we get more trains in here, of course, we're gonna need more ships to transport it off. So that's kind of expected. Okay, copper ore, food, sugar cane. Okay, that's the large distance one. That was kind of expected that that would require a little bit more. But that's nearly covered, it seems. This one, however, is not at all. Actually, that's dark red, so let me clone one more. I think that requires another two. And I think this one also requires another one of those. Other things seem to be fine. There, we seem to have a slight problem still. That seems to become better. Fruit seems to be good, except here, kind of expected. Fish to be generally alright, except down here. Yeah, we need one or two more fish trawlers here. Oh, let's add another one. There we go. Eight should cover it. Coffee seems to be alright, yes. Sugar, that's a secondary one. Rubber. Okay, this one definitely needs another. Need to do that from this platform. This one is alright. This one, however, isn't. Where do we have a depot there? Right there. Oh yes, there's tons of stuff waiting. Well, we expanded her bit off, so this station definitely can handle it. And this one. Where else? Yes, right there and right there. And this one really seems to be producing like crazy. Okay, that was rubber. The rest is fine. All the secondary cargoes we'll fix once the rest has been updated. And as you can see, we are strongly expanding into this region and into this one. All these seem to be not major towns, so I'm going to add single platforms here and just doing local services. I wanted to have the express line going first, and in this area I'm going to strongly separate the express line from my cargo and other lines, just to make sure this doesn't block too much. So I might turn this into a four-track layout, or I don't know, I may use fast trains for the cargo that actually goes to the towns, but all the industrial cargo I will use on separate tracks. One train starting the line and we have one train ending the line. This is very good. However, I'm going to slightly change the signal layout here. This should be better. That way one train can leave while the other one enters? No, not really actually. Well, maybe this additionally. Possibly help. I don't know. Just adding a few more tracks here just to allow the trains a few more possibilities to choose tracks. There we go. See, now they can pass each other because now they have different possibilities. That's a little better. And the trains seem to be spreading out nicely. I probably have to add a lot more because this line is now huge. But those are kind of the lines that I want. I also got a few ideas for the next season that I'm going to do, which is probably still a while off since we have a lot to do here still. But I have a few ideas about, again, a temperate thing that I may base on a realistic height map. And setting a custom number of cities, so the cities are... I'm going to use a bigger map, but fewer cities and fewer industries, so stuff is further away from each other. That also gives the cities a little bit more room to actually grow and not cover the entire map and have everything bunched up so that I don't have this kind of stuff, that I have everything bunched up in these huge complexes, but I have a little bit more room to work with, and cities are not just a few tiles away from each other. That way I can also use longer trains without the platforms blocking everything. I think that might be nice. Also a more realistic height map, so I have proper coastal lines. I might use a height map of Germany and the surrounding countries or something like that, and use the German train set again. But again, huge map, possibly 4K by 4K, but not with the appropriate amount of towns and industry, but less of that. So I have way more space in between, and I have a little bit more realistic distances in terms in comparison to the platform size. So that might be nice. Is this actually desert tile? No. So this doesn't need anything to grow. It just needs proper servicing. This is also not on a desert tile, neither is this one apparently. So these don't need that. This one is already growing every 35 days. That's probably due to the fact that we have 1, 2, 3 stations in this thing. All the towns that we have several stations in grow very, very fast. Actually give these guys proper stuff where they can grow into. You can possibly hook this up as well. There we go. So these guys can actually build some stuff here. Possibly even grow into this area. Oh well then. Maybe something like this. That way we can do this. Just so these guys can expand a little in that direction. Bring rate every 18 days. Wow. So these are going to grow big. Oh well. So with a look at our current major passenger line that's going all the way up there, I'm going to leave you and say keep your heads up, folks. I'll see you on the next one.